Hey trumpet nerds, welcome back to John Talks Trumpet. Today I'll be comparing two of the most commonly used buzzing aids for the trumpet, the burp and the brass buzzer. I chose to compare the burp and brass buzzer because they are the two buzzing aids recommended by the legendary James Thompson in his ultra-famous buzzing book. Mr. Thompson is the professor of trumpet at the Eastman School of Music and former principal trumpet of the Atlanta and Montreal Symphonies. I've actually had the burp for over 10 years and the brass buzzer for about 6. Of course, the cheapest and easiest way to buzz the mouthpiece is just to hold it in your hand and buzz. This is by far the simplest way to buzz, whether I'm in the car, on a camping trip, or on vacation. However, this method has downsides. In the words of James Thompson in the buzzing book, buzzing while holding the mouthpiece in the hand can lead to alterations of posture, especially in the neck and shoulder area. Thanks for that, Jim. A buzzing aid allows you to buzz the mouthpiece while holding the horn, which allows you to finger along with your own mouthpiece buzzing, which strengthens the coordination between your ears, fingers, and embouchure. These tools also allow you to work on your buzz with the same pressure distribution on your embouchure as you would use normally. Okay, let's get into the comparison. The very first thing you have to do with the burp is you use a screw to tighten the plastic around the lead pipe. Meanwhile, with the brass buzzer, you slide your mouthpiece into the ring of the brass buzzer and then seat either the mouthpiece or the solid brass end into the lead pipe. The burp makes it really easy to switch back and forth between buzzing and playing. You just grab the mouthpiece and switch it between the two receivers. Meanwhile, with the brass buzzer, you have to be careful to grab both the mouthpiece and the brass buzzer securely to switch it back and forth. There's always a risk that you might drop the buzzer if it's not securely seated on the shank of the mouthpiece. The burp is held on with a little tension from this screw, so I do worry a little bit about what would happen if it slipped while I was buzzing in the high register. Meanwhile, the brass buzzer is more secure in the instrument receiver, and I'm not afraid of pushing too hard. I'm not really sure how much force would be needed to break these two pieces apart, but I've never felt insecure about it. One extra feature that the burp has is that the mouthpiece is seated in what is essentially a plastic receiver with a closed end with some small holes around the outside that you can cover with this little hexagonal plastic piece to change the resistance of your buzz. This allows you to adjust the resistance to your preference, which definitely makes mouthpiece buzzing easier and keeps you from accidentally blowing your chops out. The resistance does make the buzzing feel more similar to how it would feel with the added resistance of the trumpet. The brass buzzer leaves the end of the mouthpiece open, just like it would be without any buzz aid. This makes buzzing the mouthpiece with no added resistance require more physical effort, which aligns with how I personally use mouthpiece buzzing, as a form of overtraining and not necessarily trying to emulate trumpet playing as closely as possible. When you're done buzzing, the burp sort of encourages you to just leave it attached to the lead pipe with the tension screw, which I don't love because the extra plastic absorbs vibrations to the mouthpiece and the lead pipe and offers no projection benefit. Taking it on and off every time can also be kind of irritating if you have a lead pipe with a wide receiver design. The brass buzzer is easier to put away. I suppose you could just leave it on the mouthpiece, but it would certainly affect how the mouthpiece responds, like a poorly designed mouthpiece booster. I always just take it off and put it back in my mouthpiece case. Okay, let's get into some additional considerations. One nice thing about the burp is that it's made mostly of plastic, which means that if you drop it on or near your instrument, you won't have to worry about damaging your horn. Since the brass buzzer is actually made of brass, there's always the risk that you could either scratch the shank of your mouthpiece or dent your instrument if you dropped it. Just to compare, the burp is 14.2 grams and this brass buzzer was 26.5 grams. Since the burp is closed at the end, spit won't fall onto your clothes or shirt, which is really nice. But unfortunately, there's also not anywhere for that spit to go and it won't be that easy to clean out the inside of the burp. Maybe a Q-tip and some soap and water would work. With the brass buzzer, there's not really anything to clean. It's just this small brass piece that goes into the receiver. However, since the mouthpiece is open at the end and you're holding the trumpet normally, a little spittle will definitely get onto your shirt or pants if you buzz long enough. Normally, this isn't a big deal because it dries out quickly, but it's still worth noting. Both the burp and the brass buzzer are available for not only the trumpet, but also the cornet, the horn, small, large, and extra large shank trombone and euphonium, and tuba. The burp is $21.95 on burp.com, and the brass buzzer is $22.95 on brassbuzzer.com. If you want to get a bunch for your marching band or big band program, you can order them in bulk and get a discount. The burp has several strong points to it, especially the ability to adjust the buzzing resistance. And it's handy to have it attached to the lead pipe for any buzzing emergency. That said, I do tend to use the brass buzzer more often for several reasons. It holds the mouthpiece more securely, it's a lot easier to take on and off the trumpet, and it is the most similar to playing the mouthpiece without the horn attached, because the end of the mouthpiece is unobstructed. Really, either one is a great product worth considering, especially considering their small differential in price. I really hope you've enjoyed this comparison video between the B.E.R.P. and the brass buzzer. Thank you so much for joining me on today's episode of John Talks Trumpet. If you enjoyed this video and would like to see more nerdy trumpet content, please like and subscribe to this channel. New videos every Tuesday.